chair and turned on channel two. A bad gunslinger called Salty Sam was a chasing Poe Sweet Sue. He trapped her in the old sawmill and said with an evil laugh,
"If you don't give me the deed to your ranch, I'll saw you all in half."
And then he grabbed her.
And then
he tied her up.
And then
he turned on the buzz saw.
And then, and then,
and then along came John. Talking Jones. Slow walking Jones.
Slow talking Jones.
Along came lonely, lanky Jones.
Commercial came on, so I got up to get myself a snack. You should have seen what was going on by the time that I got back. Down in the old abandoned mine, Sweet Sue of the heaven fits. That villain said,
"Give me the deed to your ranch, I'll blow you all to bits."
And then he grabbed her.
And then
he tied her up.
And then
he lit the fuse to the dynamite.
And then, and then,
and then along came John. Talking Jones. Slow walking Jones.
Slow talking Jones.
Along came lonely, lanky Jones.
Show. But there was the same old shoot 'em up and the same old rodeo. Salty Sam was a trying to stuff Sweet Sue in a burlap sack.
He said,
"If you don't give me the deed to your ranch, I'm gonna throw you on the railroad track."
And then he grabbed her.
And then
he tied her up.
And then
he threw on the railroad track.
And then
that train started coming.
And then, and then,
and then along came John. Talking Jones. Slow walking Jones.
Slow talking Jones.
Along came lonely, lanky Jones.
After the turn of the century, in the clear blue skies over Germany, came a roar and a thunder men had never heard, like the screaming sound of a big war bird. Up in the sky, a man in a plane, Baron von Richthofen was his name. Amen, try.
Curses wild again.
10, 20, 30, 40, 50 or more. The bloody red bear was rolling up a score. Amen, died trying to end that spree of the bloody red bear of Germany. Now Snoopy had sworn that he'd get that man, so he asked the great pumpkin for a new battle plan. He challenged the German to a real dog fight. While the Baron was laughing, he got him in his sight. Try everything, but he'd run out of tricks. spinning out of sight. 10, 20, 30, 40, 50 or more. The bloody red bear was running the score. 8 and 9, trying to end that spree of the bloody red bear of Germany.
Hey, sit down, fella. You can't come up. what it takes. There ain't no doubt. Strawberry and the shortcakes. Work it on out.
I'm a nut, I'm a nut. My life don't ever get in a rut. The head on my shoulders is sort of loose, and I ain't got sense God gave a goose. Lord, I ain't crazy, but I'm a nut. Is it wetter underwater if you're there when it rains? Is it shorter to New York than it is by plane? Between myself and I wonder who's the dumber. Is it hotter down south than it is in the summer? I'm a nut, I'm a nut. My life don't ever get in a rut. The head on my shoulders is sort of loose, and I ain't got sense God gave a goose. Lord, I ain't crazy, but I'm a nut. I drove my Cadillac to Vegas to satisfy my lust. Will and deal and left old Vegas on a Greyhound bus. I sure didn't set the woods on fire while I was there, but remember only forest fires prevent bears. Deep deep ba ba da ba be ba ba da ba 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 da ba ba. I'm a nut, I'm a nut. My life don't ever get in a rut. The head on my shoulders is sort of loose, and I ain't got sense God gave a goose. Lord, I ain't crazy, but I'm a nut. The poverty war will be over when I begin to fight. If it took a dime to go around the world, I couldn't get out of sight. I don't mind to take the girls out if they don't mind to go Dutch. Makes me feel like $1 million, and I bet I ain't worth half that much. I'm a nut, I'm a nut. My life don't ever get in a rut. The head on my shoulders is sort of loose, and I ain't got sense God gave a goose. Lord, I ain't crazy, but I'm a nut.
We interrupt this record to bring you a special bulletin. The reports of a flying saucer hovering over the city have been confirmed. The flying saucers are real.
Real, well, I feel what my heart can't conceal.
That was the Clatters recording. Too real. We switch you now to our on-the-spot reporter downtown.
Come on, baby, let's go downtown.
Take it away, John Cameron Cameron.
This is John Cameron Cameron downtown. Pardon me, madam. Would you tell our audience what would you do if the saucer were to land?
Get back in the air!
Thank you. And now the thin gentleman there.
What I'm gonna do is hard to tell.
The gentleman with the guitar. What would you do, sir?
I'm gonna take a walk down the street.
Thank you. We return you now.
This is Grant, your outer space disc jockey, with a request for Earth.
Earth Angel, Earth Angel.
That was the Pelicans' outer space recording Earth. I've just been handed a bulletin. The flying saucer has just landed. We switch you again downtown.
Here we are again. We have with us Professor Sir Cedric Fentingmold of the British Institute. The professor is approaching the saucer to see if there's possibly any sign of life aboard.
Well, I'm sure something. Are you there?
I hear you knocking. But you can't come in.
That was Laughing Lewis's record. Knocking.
This is John Cameron Cameron on the spot. And now I believe we're about to hear the words of the first spaceman ever to land on Earth.
La, ba, boo, ma, la, ba, boo.
And now, here are the bowl scores.
4-3, 6-2, and 8-1.
The impact of seeing the first spaceman has this reporter reeling.
Here I go, reeling.
That was the Clatters again, with their big one, Oh!
This is John Cameron, Cameron again downtown. The spaceman has returned to his ship and is taking off. We return you now to our studios.
The flying saucer has gone. There is no threat of an invasion. However, the flying saucers are still around.
We are not going to interrupt this record.
Yes, we are. The flying saucer has landed again. Washington, the Secretary of Defense has just said...
Be that a shame.
That was Skinny Dynamo's record. That's a shame.
This is John Cameron, Cameron Part 2. Gathered around me are several of the spacemen. Tell us, have you come to conquer the world?
Snap at the earth.
And now would you repeat that in English?
Don't want the world to have and hold.
Hey, why don't you go back where you came from?
Don't be angry and drive me away.
We return you now to our studios.
Here is a news item from Washington. The president has just issued a statement to the spacemen, and we quote...
You can do anything for me, off of my blue suede shoes.
That was Pa Gherkin's record, Shoes.
We switch you again downtown.
This is John Cameron, Cameron downtown.
Professor Cedric of the British Institute, tell us, how were the saucers able to land?
Where do you see...
The motor cooled down, the heat went down.
That was Huckleberry's recording, The Motor Cooled Down.
This is John Cameron, Cameron again. I believe the spaceman has a final parting word.
See you later, alligator.
We return you now to our studios.
The spacemen have gone again, but look to the skies. The saucers will always be there.
Always be there.
Goodbye, Earth people.
Sit high, getting ideas. Ain't nothing but a fool to live like this. Out all night and running wild. A woman sitting home with a month-old child. Dang me, dang me. They ought to take a rope and hang me. High from the highest tree. Woman, would you weep for me? One more time. Just sitting around drinking with the rest of the guys. Six rounds bought and I bought five. And I spent the groceries and half the rent. I like $14.27. Well, dang me, dang me. They ought to take a rope and hang me. High from the highest tree. Woman, would you weep for me? One more time. Roses are red and violets are purple. Sugar's sweet and so's maple syrup. I'm the seventh out of seven sons. Pappy's a pistol, I'm a son of a gun. Well, dang me, dang me. Down take a rope and hang me. High from the highest tree. Woman, would you weep for me?
I told the witch doctor I was in love with you. I told the witch doctor I was in love with you. And then the witch doctor, he told me what to do. He said that... I told the witch doctor you didn't love me true. I told the witch doctor you didn't love me nice. And then the witch doctor, he gave me this advice. He said that, ooh-ee, ooh-ah, So much wiser, and he taught me the way to win your heart. My friend, the witch doctor, he taught me what to say. My friend, the witch doctor, he taught me what to do. I know that you'll be mine when I say this to you. Ooh ee, ooh ah ah, ting tang, walla walla bing bang. Ooh ee, ooh ah ah, ting tang, walla walla bang bang. Ooh ee, ooh ah ah, ting tang, walla walla bing bang. Ooh ee, ooh ah ah, ting tang, walla walla bang bang. Keeping love from me just like you were a miser, and I'll admit I wasn't very smart. So I went out and found myself a guy that's so much wiser, and he taught me the way to win your heart. My friend, the witch doctor, he taught me what to say. My friend, the witch doctor, he taught me what to do. I know that you'll be mine when I say this to you, oh baby. Ooh ee, ooh ah ah, ting tang, walla walla bing bang. Ah ah, ting tang, walla walla bang bang, come on in. Ooh ee, ooh ah ah, ting tang, walla walla bing bang. Ooh ee, ooh ah ah, ting tang, walla walla bang bang. Ooh ee, ooh ah ah, ting tang, walla walla bing bang. Ooh ee, ooh ah ah, ting tang, walla walla bang bang. Ooh ee, ooh ah ah, ting tang, walla walla bing bang. Ooh ee, ooh ah ah, ting tang, walla walla bang bang. Ooh ee.
1, 2, 1, 2.
Mr. Bassman, you've got that certain something. Mr. Bassman, you set that music thumping. To you it's easy when you go 1, 2, 3. Yeah, Mr. Bassman, you're on all the songs with a boom boom and a boom boom boom. Hey, Mr. Bassman, you're the hidden king of rock and roll. Oh, it don't mean a thing when the lead is singing or when he goes hi-yi. Hey, Mr. Bassman, I'm asking just one thing. Will you teach me? Yeah, the way you sing. Cause Mr. Bassman, I wanna be a bassman too. Mr. Bassman, I really think I'm with it. Boom boom. Come on, Mr. Bassman. Now I'm a bassman. Teach me, yeah, the way you sing. Cause Mr. Bassman, I wanna be a bassman too. Yeah, Mr. Bassman, I think I'm really with it. Boom boom, and a boom boom. Come on, Mr. Bassman, now I'm a bassman too.
Beans in my ears.
the teacher with beans in your ears.
Beans in your ears, beans in your ears.
Can't hear the teacher with beans in your ears.
Beans in your ears.
What's that you say?
Let's put beans in our ears.
Beans in our ears.
Beans in our ears.
What's that you say?
Let's put beans in our ears.
Just don't put those beans in your ears.
Beans in our ears. I think that all grown-ups have beans in their ears. Beans in their ears. Beans in their ears. I think that all grown-ups have beans in their ears. Beans in their ears.
For my monster from his slab began to rise, and suddenly, to my surprise,
he did the mash.
He did the monster mash.
The monster mash.
It was a graveyard smash.
He did the mash.
It caught on in a flash.
He did the mash.
He did the monster mash. From my laboratory in the castle east to the master bedroom where the vampires feast. The ghouls all came from their humble abode to get a jolt from my electrode.
They did the mash.
They did the monster mash.
The monster mash.
It was a graveyard smash.
They did the mash.
It caught on in a flash.
They did the mash.
They did the monster mash. The zombies were having fun. The party had just begun. The guests included Wolfman, Dracula, and his son. The scene was rocking, all were digging the sounds. Igor on chains, backed by his baying hounds. The coffin bangers were about to arrive with their vocal group, the Crypt Kicker Five.
They played the mash.
They played the monster mash.
The monster mash.
It was a graveyard smash.
They played the mash.
It caught on in a flash.
They played the mash.
They played the monster mash. Out from his coffin, Drac's voice did ring. Seemed he was troubled by just one thing. Opened the lid and shook his fist and said, whatever happened to my Transylvania twist?
It's now the mash.
It's now the monster mash.
The monster mash.
And it's a graveyard smash.
It's now the mash.
It's caught on in a flash.
It's now the mash.
It's now the monster mash. Now everything's cool. Drac's a part of the band, and my monster mash is the hit of the land. For you, the living, this mash was meant to. When you get to my door, tell them Boris sent
you. Then you can mash.
Then you can monster mash.
The monster mash.
And do my graveyard smash.
Then you can mash.
You'll catch on in a flash.
Then you can mash.
Then you can monster mash.
Mash.
Easy, Igor. You impetuous young boy.
Mash. Good.
Monster mash.
Hi, kids.
Hi, Tom.
Let's sing a little bit. On top of spaghetti.
On top of spaghetti.
Oh,
covered with cheese.
All covered with cheese.
I lost my poor meatball.
I lost my poor meatball.
When somebody sneezed.
When somebody sneezed.
It rolled off the table.
It rolled off the table.
And onto the floor.
And onto the floor.
And then my poor meatball. Rolled out of the door.
Rolled out of the door.
It rolled in the garden.
It rolled in the garden.
And under a bush.
And under a bush.
And then my poor meatball.
And then my poor meatball.
Was nothing but mush.
Was nothing but mush.
All right, now I'll tell you the words. You sing it back to me. On top of spaghetti.
On top of spaghetti.
All covered with cheese.
I
lost my poor meatball.
I lost my poor meatball.
When somebody sneezed.
When somebody sneezed.
It rolled off the table.
It rolled off the table.
And onto the floor.
And onto the floor.
And then my poor meatball.
And then my poor meatball.
Rolled out of the door.
Rolled out of the door.
It rolled in the garden.
It rolled in the garden.
And under a bush.
Then
my poor meatball.
And then my poor meatball.
Was nothing but mush.
Was nothing but mush.
Oh, the mush was as tasty.
Oh, the mush was as tasty.
As tasty could be.
As tasty could be.
And early next summer.
And early next summer.
It grew into a tree.
It grew into a tree.
Well, the tree was all covered.
Well, the tree was all covered.
With beautiful moss.
With beautiful.
It grew lovely meatballs.
It grew lovely meatballs.
And tomato sauce.
And tomato sauce.
So if you eat spaghetti.
So if you eat spaghetti.
All covered with cheese.
All covered with cheese.
Hold on to your meatball.
Hold on to your meatball.
And don't ever sneeze. And don't ever.
Let me startle you. I'm just doing the rebel yell here to kind of kick things off. You know what I mean? There's yellow rose in Texas that I am gonna say. Nobody else could miss her, not half as much as me. She cried so when I let her part of me. That's just a shade loud on the snare drum.
She's the sweetest little rosebud that Texas Avenue. Her eyes are bright as diamonds. They sparkle like the dew.
Now you covered up sparkle like the dew. One of the loveliest parts in the whole
Texas is the only girl for me.
You covered up the piccolos there with a Rio Grande. With a Rio. Where? What? See, my feeling is that while I love a good snare drum, I feel that volume-wise, it's just a little bit too much what you're doing there. See? See? See what I mean? Now you try and hold it down, will you? Appreciate it. Appreciate it. Where the Rio Grande? Appreciate it. Where the Rio Grande is flowing and starry sky, that's better. She walks along the river on the quiet. Oh, that's so much better. I know that she remembers when they parted long ago. You know that there's just a world of difference. Mercy.
She's the sweetest little rosebud that Texas Avenue. Her eyes are bright as diamonds. They sparkle like you.
See, now you're slipping back in your old habits again. Why do you do that? Why do you?
Texas is the only girl for me.
I love a good snare drum, but you know. People, let's go back there. The snare drama covered up the tra-la-las. We just do it again. Smart Ellie. You see how lovely that turned out? Now that's a darling part. Okay, banjo. That's pretty, that's pretty. Oh, now I'm going to that's pretty. For my heart is full of woe. We'll do the things together we did so long ago. We'll play the banjo gaily. She loves me like me. Excuse me. You ain't any kin to the snare drummer, are you?
She's the sweetest little rosebud that Texas has.
Why do you do that? Why do you burst out like that. That irritates me. That irritates me. That irritates me, that's all.
But the yellow rose of Texas.
Hold on! Hold on! Hold on! You smart aleck Yankee drummer, you. You can cover up yelling. You can cover up rose, buddy, buddy. But don't you cover up Texas. Or I'll stick your head through that cotton picking snare drum and secede from the band. So help me, Mitch Miller, I will.
And the yellow rose of Texas will be mine forevermore.
Cut it off there. The record's over. You idiot. Stop it. Stop it, I'll say. Just stop it now. Stop it. I'm getting out of here. He ruined the ending. One of the loveliest parts in the whole... Peace.
Let me tell you about Ahab, the Arab, the sheik of the burning sands. He had emeralds and rubies just a-dripping off of him and a ring on every finger of his hand. He wore a big old turban wrapped around his head and a scimitar by his side. And every evening about midnight he'd jump on his camel named Clyde and ride silently through the night to the Sultan's tent, where he would secretly meet up with Fatima of the Seven Veils, the swingin'est number one dancer in the Sultan's whole harem. Cause like him and her had a thing going, you know, and they've been carrying on for some time now behind the Sultan's back. And you could hear him talk to his camel as he rode out across the dunes. His voice would cut through the still night desert air, and he'd say, oh, yeah, 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 oh, yeah, 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 yeah. Which is Aramaic for whoa, babies. And Clyde say, well, he brought his camel to a screeching halt in the rear of Fatima's tent. Jumped off Clyde, snuck around the corner and into the tent he went. There he saw Fatima laying on a zebra skin rug, with rings on her fingers and bells on her toes and a bone in her nose, ho, ho. There she was, friends and neighbors laying there in all her radiant beauty, eating on a raisin and a grape and an apricot and a pomegranate, a bowl of chitterlings, two bananas, three Hershey bars, and sipping on an ROC Coca-Cola, listening to her transistor, watching the Grand Ole Opry, and reading Mad Magazine while she sung, does your chewing gum lose its flavor? And Ahab walk up to her and he say, oh yeah, 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 oh 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 yeah. Which is Aramaic for, let's twist again like we did last summer, babies. And she say,
crazy, baby.
All of a sudden the Sultan walked in. Ahab knew that this was the end. Him and Fatima was caught by surprise, and the Sultan had fire flashing out of his eyes. Well, the Sultan charged at Ahab, intending to make a dent in his head, but he fled with Fatima, and out of the tent they went. They jumped on Clyde and started to ride, cutting out across the sand, with the Sultan's whole army in hot pursuit. On and on they ran. Well, to make a long story short, they got away, cause there weren't no animal alive what could keep up with Clyde once he got started, cause he was the swiftest steed on the old desert babies. And they made it across the border where Ahab hopped all his rubies and emeralds, and they bought him a swanging little split-level pad and lived happy ever after. Yeah, and that's the story about Ahab, the Arab, the sheik of the burning sand.
the night. All the ladies were treating me right, moving my feet to the disco beat. How in the world could I keep my seat?
Yes or is it no? Does your chewing gum lose its flavour on the bedpost overnight? If your mother says don't chew it, do you swallow it in spite? Can you catch it on your tonsils? Can you heave it left and right? Does your chewing gum lose its flavour on the bedpost overnight? Here comes a blushing bride, the groom is by her side. Up to the altar, just as steady as Gibraltar, while the groom has got the ring. But as he slips it on, her finger the choir begins to sing. Does your chewing gum lose its flavour on the bedpost overnight? If your mother said don't chew it, do you swallow it in spite? Can you catch it on your tonsils? Can you heave it left and right? Does your chewing gum lose its flavour on the bedpost overnight? Now the nation rises one to send their honoured sons. Oh, unto the president, upon the burning question, what has swept this continent? If tin whistles are made of tin, what do they make foghorns out of?
Boom, boom!
Does your chewing gum lose its flavour on the bedpost overnight? If your mother says don't chew it, do you swallow it in spite? Can you catch it on your tonsils? Can you heave it left and right? Does your chewing gum lose its flavour on the bedpost overnight?
Did you? Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday night on the big bone overnight.
It's a dollar and a dime, it's a dime.
He's singing another chorus, but he hasn't got the time.
On the big bone overnight. Yeah.
Pouring out of the blue, a little arrow's
Some folks are run and others hide, but there ain't nothing they can do. And some folks put on armor, but the arrows go straight through. So you see, there's no escape, so why not face it and admit that you love those little arrows when they hurt a little bit. Here they come pouring out of the blue, little arrows for me and for you.
Clothes. He wears tan shoes with pink shoelaces, a polka dot vest, and man, oh man, he wears tan shoes with pink shoelaces and a big Panama with a purple hat band. He takes me deep sea fishing in a submarine. We go to drive-in movies in a limousine. He's got a portly birdie and a 12-foot yacht. Ah, but that's not all he's got. He's got tan shoes with pink shoelaces, a polka dot vest, and man, oh man, he wears tan shoes with pink shoelaces and a big Panama with a purple hat band. Now Dooley had a feeling we were going to war, so he went out and enlisted in a fighting corps. But he landed in the rig for raising such a storm when they tried to put him in a uniform. He wanted tan shoes with pink shoelaces, a polka dot vest, and man oh man, he wanted tan shoes with pink shoelaces and a big Panama with a purple hat band. One day Doobie started feeling sick, and he decided that he better make his whittle out quick. He said,
just before the angels come to carry me, I want to down in writing how to bury me.
A wearing tan shoes with pink shoelaces, a polka dot vest, and man oh man, a gave me tan shoes with pink shoelaces and a big Panama with a purple hat band. Purple Hat Band.
I'd like to thank the guy who wrote the song that made my baby fall in love with me. Who put the bomb in the bomb a bomb a bomb? Who put the rhyme in the ram-a-lam-a ding dong? Who put the bop in the bop shabop shabop? Who put the dip in the dip dip dip? Who was that man? I'd like to shake his hand. He made my baby fall in love with me.
Yeah.
When my baby heard bom-ba-ba-bom-ba-bom-ba-bom, every word went right into her heart. And when she heard them singing ram-a-lam-a-lam-a-lam-a-lam-a-ding-dong, she said we'd never have to part. So who put the bop in the bom-ba-bom-ba-bom? Who put the rhyme in the ram-a-lam-a-ding-dong? Who put the bop in the bop-shabop-shabop? Who put the dip in the dip dip dip? Who was that man? I'd like to shake his hand. He made my baby fall in love with me.
Yeah.
Each time that we're alone, boogity 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 shoot, sets my baby's heart all aglow. And every time we dance to dip 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 dip, she always says she loves me so. So who put the bop in the bop a bop a bop? Who put the rhyme in the ram-a-lam-a-ding-dong? Who put the bop in the bop shoo bop shoo bop? Who put the dip in the dip dip dip? Who was that man? I'd like to shake his hand. He made my baby fall in love with me.
Yeah.
Darling, bom bop a bom bop bom bop bom bom, and my honey, ram-a-lam-a-ding-dong, forever. And when I say dip-di-dip, di-dip, di-dip, you know I mean it from the bottom of my boogity, boogity, boogity shoe.
What she wore.
It was an itsy bitsy teeny weeny yellow polka dot bikini that she wore for the first time today. An itsy bitsy teeny weeny yellow polka dot bikini, so in the locker she wanted to stay.
2, 3, 4, stick around, we'll tell you more.
Bum, 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 bum.
She was afraid to come out in the open, so a blanket around her she wore. She was afraid to come out in the open, and so she sat bundled up on the shelf.
2, 3, 4, tell the people what she wore.
It was an itsy bitsy teeny weeny yellow polka dot bikini that she wore for the first time today. An itsy bitsy teeny weeny
we'll tell you more.
Now she's afraid to come out of the water, and I wonder what she's gonna do. Now she's afraid to come out of the water, and the poor little girl's turning blue.
2, 3, 4, tell the people what she wore.
It was an itsy bitsy teeny weeny yellow polka dot bikini that she wore for the first time today. Itsy-bitsy, teeny-weeny, yellow polka dot bikini, so in the water she wanted to stay.
From the locker to the blanket,
from the blanket to the shore,
from the shore to the water,
guess there isn't any more.
There's a man in the funny papers we all know. He lives way back a long time ago. He don't eat nothing but a bearcat stew. Well, this cat's name is Alley-Oo. Got a chauffeur that's a genuine dinosaur, and he can knuckle your head before you count to four. He got a big ugly club and a head full of howl, like great big lions and grizzly bears. The toughest man there is alive. Wearing clothes from a wildcat's hide. He's the king of the jungle jive.
Look at that caveman go.
He rides through the jungle tearing limbs off of trees. Knocking great big monsters dead on their knees. The cats don't bug him cause they know better. Cause he's a mean motor scooter and a bad go-getter. He's the toughest man there is alive. Wears clothes from a wildcat's hide. He's the king of the jungle jive.
Look at that kid man.
Look at that caveman go. He sure is hip, ain't he? Like what's happening? He's too much. Ride, daddy, ride. Hi-yo, dinosaur. Ride, daddy, ride. Get him.
Fuck me! While riding in my Cadillac, what to my surprise, a little Nash Rambler was following me about 1/3 my size. The guy must have wanted to pass me out as he kept on tooting his horn. I'll show him that a Cadillac is not a car to scorn. Beep, 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 beep. His horn went beep, beep, beep. I pushed my foot down to the floor to give the guy the shake, but the little Nash Rambler stayed right behind. He still had on his brake. He must have thought his car had more guts as he kept on tooting his horn. I'll show him that a Cadillac is not a car to scorn. Beep, 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 beep. His horn went beep, beep, beep. My car went into passing gear and we took off with gust. Soon we were doing 90, must have left him in the dust. When I peeked in the mirror of my car, I couldn't believe my eyes. The little Nash Rambler was right behind. I think that guy could fly. Beep, 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 beep. His horn went beep, beep, beep. Now we're doing 110, this certainly was a race. For a Rambler to pass a caddy would be a big disgrace. The guy must have wanted to pass me out, he's kept on tooting his horn. I'll show him that a Cadillac is not a car to scorn. Beep, 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 beep. His horn went beep, beep, beep. Now we're doing 120 as fast as I could go. The Rambler pulled alongside of me as if we're going slow. The fellow rolled down his window and yelled for me to hear. Hey buddy, how can I get this car out of second gear?
Fred dropped the F's, Bo Red, or Mary, Mary dropped the M's. legend you are about to hear is true, only the needle should be changed to protect the record.
This is the countryside. My name is St. George. I'm a knight. Saturday, July 10th, 8:05 p.m. I was working out of the castle on the night watch when a call came in from the chief. A dragon had been devouring maidens. Homicide. My job. Slay him. You call me, chief?
Yeah, it's the dragon again, devouring maidens. The king's daughter may be next.
Mm-hmm. You got a lead?
Nothing much to go on. Said you take that .45 automatic into the lab to have him check on it?
Yeah. You were right.
I was right?
Yeah. It was a gun. 8:22 p.m. I talked to one of the maidens who had almost been devoured. Could I talk to you, ma'am?
Who are you?
I'm St. George, ma'am. Homicide, ma'am. I want to ask you a few questions, ma'am. I understand you were almost devoured by the man. Is that right, dragon?
It was terrible. He breathed fire on me. He baned me already.
How can I be sure of that, ma'am?
Believe me, I got it straight from the dragon's mouth.
11:45 p.m. I rode over the King's Highway. I saw a man. Stopped to talk to him. Pardon me, sir. Could I talk to you for just a minute, sir?
Sure, I don't mind.
What do you do for a living?
I'm a knave.
Didn't they pick you up on a 903 last year for stealing tarts?
Yeah? So what, do you want to make a federal case out of it?
No, sir. We heard there was a dragon operating in this neighborhood. We just want to know if you've seen him.
Sure, I've seen him.
Mm-hmm. Could you describe him for me?
What's to describe? You see one dragon, you've seen them all.
Would you try and remember, sir, just for the record? We just want to get the facts, sir.
Well, he was, you know, he had orange polka dots.
Yes, sir.
Purple feet, breathing fire and smoke.
Mm-hmm.
And one big bloodshot eye right in the middle of his forehead, and, like that.
Notice anything unusual about him?
No, he's just a run-of-the-mill dragon, you know.
Mm-hmm. Yes, sir, you can go now.
Hey, by the way, how are you going to catch him?
I thought you'd never ask. A dragon net. 3:05 p.m. I was riding back into the courtyard to make my report to the lab. Then it happened. It was a dragon.
Hey, I'm the fire-breathing dragon. You must be St. George, right?
Yes, sir.
I see you got one of them new 45 caliber swords.
That's about the size of it.
You slay me.
That's what I wanted to talk to you about.
What do you mean?
I'm taking it in a 502. You figure it out.
What's the charge?
Devouring maidens out of season.
Out of season? You never pinned that rap on me. Do you hear me, cop?
Yeah, I hear you. I got you in a 412, too.
A 412? What's a 412?
Overacting. Let's go.
On September the 5th, the dragon was tried and convicted. His fire was put out, and his maiden devouring license revoked. Maiden devouring out of season is punishable by a term of not less than 50 or more than 300 years.
Hello, everyone. This is your Action News reporter with all the news that is news across the nation on the scene at the supermarket. There seems to have been some disturbance here. Pardon me, sir. Did you see what happened?
Yeah, I did. I was standing over by the tomatoes, and here he comes. Running through the pole beans, through the fruits and vegetables, naked as a jaybird. And I hollered over to Ethel. I said, "Don't look, Ethel!" And it's too late. She'd already been in since.
Here comes.
Boogity, boogity.
There goes.
Boogity, boogity.
And he ain't wearing no clothes.
Oh, yes, they call him the street.
Boogity, boogity.
Fastest thing on 2 feet.
Boogity, boogity.
He's just as proud as he can be. His anatomy. Gonna give us a peek. Oh yes, they call him the street.
Boogity, boogity.
He likes to show off his physique.
Boogity, boogity.
If there's an audience to be found, he'll be streaking it round, inviting public critique.
This is your Action News reporter once again, and we're here at the gas station. Pardon me, sir, did you see what happened?
Yeah, Dave. I was just in here getting my tires checked, and he just appeared out of the traffic. Come streaking around the grease right there. Didn't have nothing on but a smile. I looked in there and Ethel was getting her cold drink. I hollered, "Don't look, Ethel!" And it's too late. She'd already been mooned. Flashed her right there in front of the shop or so.
He ain't rude.
Boogity, boogity.
He ain't rude.
Boogity, boogity.
He's just in the mood to ride in the nude.
Oh, yes, they call him the street.
Boogity, boogity.
turn the other cheek. He's always making the news, wearing just his tennis shoes. Guess you could call him unique.
Once again, your Action News reporter in the booth at the gym, covering the disturbance at the basketball playoff. Pardon me, sir, did you see what happened?
Yeah, Dee. Hey, Tom, I was just going down there to get Ethel a snow cone. Here he come, right out of the cheap seats. Dribbling. Right down the middle of the court. Didn't have on nothing but his PS. Made a hook shot and got out through the concession stand. I hollered up at Ethel. I said, "Don't look, Ethel!" It was too late. She'd already got a free shot. Grandstand. Right there in front of the home team.
What is it calling the street?
Here it comes again. Who's that with it? Ethel. Is that you, Ethel?
He's just as proud as he can be.
What do you think you're doing?
Listen to me. He gonna give us a
You
key.
Get your clothes on.
What is it calling the street?
Ethel, where you go?
Take out the papers and the trash, or you don't get no spending cash. If you don't scrub that kitchen floor, you ain't gonna rock and roll no more. Yaggy yak!
Don't go back.
Just finish cleaning up your room. Let's see that dust fly with that broom. You just put on your coat and hat and walk yourself to the laundromat. And when you finish doing that, bring in the dog and put out the cat. Yaggity-yak!
Don't hold back.
Looks. Your father's hip, he knows what cooks.
Just tell your hoodlum friend outside. You ain't got time to take a ride. Yaggity yak!
Don't go back.
Yaggity yak, yaggity yak.
Keep a date with my little girl who was back in the States. I was stranded in the jungle, afraid and alone, trying to figure a way to get a message back home. But I was out to know that the wreckage of my plane had been picked up and spotted in my girl in Lover's Lane. And meanwhile, back in the States.
Baby, baby.
Meanwhile, back in the jungle. The boys in the jungle had me on the run when something heavy hit me like an atomic bomb. When I woke up and my head started to clear, I had a strange feeling I was with cooking gear. I smelled something cooking and I looked to see. That's when I found out they was cooking me. Meanwhile, back in the States.
Baby, baby, let's make romance. You know your old-time lover hasn't got a chance. He's standing in the jungle flattest. He can be so come on, pretty baby, just you and me.
Meanwhile, back in the jungle. I jumped out the pot and I finally got away, frantic and worried about what my baby was saying. So I jumped in the ocean and started to swim, for my chance of survival was getting mighty slim. So I thumbed down a whale who was in my way, and I reached the States in about a half a day. And when I got to Lover's Lane, I was almost dead, but my soul was gone, and here's what I said.
I was walking down the street, spied a beggar man with rags upon his feet. Took a penny from my pocket in his tin cup, I did drop it, and I heard him say as I made my retreat,
"May the bird of paradise fly up your nose, may an elephant caress you with his toes, in her hose. May the bird of paradise fly up your nose."
My laundry man is really on his toes. Found $100 bill among my clothes. When he called me, I came running, gave him back his dime for phoning, and I heard him saying as I turned to go,
"May the bird of paradise fly up your nose, may an elephant caress you with his toes, may your wife be plagued with runners in her hose, may the bird of paradise fly up your nose."
Thank you.
I was way behind one day to catch a train. The taxi driver said, we'll make it just the same. A speed cop made it with us, and as he wrote out the ticket, I stood by politely waiting for my change.
May the bird of paradise fly up your nose. May an elephant caress you with his toes. May you wipe the flag with runners in her hose. May the bird of paradise fly up your nose. May the bird of paradise fly up your nose. May an elephant caress you with his toes. May you wipe the flag with runners in her hose. May the bird of paradise.
To save my soul.
Troubles down to Madame Ruth. You know that gypsy with the gold cap tooth. She's got a pad on 34th and Vine, selling little bottles of love potion number 9. I told her that I was a flop with chicks. I've been this way since 1956. She looked at my palm and she made a magic sign. She said, what you need is love potion number 9. She bent down and turned around and gave me a wink. She said, I'm gonna mix it up right here in the sink. It smelled like turpentine and looked like India ink. I held my nose, I closed my eyes,
I took a drink.
I didn't know it was a day or night. I started kissing everything in sight. But when I kissed a cop at 34th and Vine, he broke my little bottle of love potion number 9.
Took a drink.
I didn't know it was a day or night. I started kissing everything in sight.
I had so much fun that I'm going back again. I wonder what happened with love potion number 10, love potion number 9, love potion number 9, love potion number 9.
Let's put bucket down. I said, wait a minute, dear. I know you mean it just for play. I said, wait a minute, Gator, I know you mean it just for play. Don't you know you really hurt me? And this is what I have to say.
See you later, alligator. After a while, crocodile.
He lives in the jungle and hangs by his knees as he swings through the trees without a trapeze in his BVD. He's got a union card and he's practicing hard to play the guitar. Gonna be a big star, yeah, he's gonna go far and carry moonbeams home in a jar. He ordered Chet's guitar core, COD, makes A and E, and he's working on B. Dig C and W and R and B, and me and a chimpanzee agree that one day soon he'll be a celebrity. Get it, get it, get it, get it out! Guitar Zan, he's a guitar man, he's all you can stand. Give him a hand, Guitar Zan. He's got a girl named Jane with no last name, kinda homely and plain, but he loves her just the same, cause she kindles a flame and it drives him insane when he hears her sing. She really does her thing, it's her claim to fame. Come on, sing one, Jane.
monkey. He likes to get drunk and sing boogie woogie, and it sounds real funky. Come on, your time, boy. Sing one, monkey. Here we go. Let's hear it for the monkey. Woo! On Saturday night, they need some excitement. Jane gets right and the monkey gets tight, and their voices unite in the pale moonlight, and it sounds all right. Yeah, it's dynamite. It's out of sight. Let's hear it right now.
In a buffalo herd, can't roller skate in a buffalo herd. You can't roller skate in a buffalo herd, but you can be happy if you've mine too. You can't take a shower in a parakeet cage. Can't take a shower in a parakeet cage. Can't take a shower in a parakeet cage, but you can be happy if you've mine too. All you gotta do is put your mind to it. Knuckle down, buckle down, do it, do it, do it. Well, you can't go swimming in a baseball pool. You can't go swimming in a baseball pool. You can't go swimming in a baseball pool, but you can be happy if you've mine too. Kid on your back, can't change film with the kid on your back. Can't change film with the kid on your back, but you can be happy if you've mine too. You can't drive around with a tiger in your car. Can't drive around with a tiger in your car. You can't drive around with a tiger in your car, but you can be happy if you've mine too. All you gotta do is put your mind to it. Knuckle down, buckle down, do it, do it, do it. Well, you can't roller skate in the buffalo herd. Can't roller skate in the buffalo herd. You can't roller skate in the buffalo herd, but you can be happy if you've mine too. You can't go fishing in a watermelon patch. You can't go fishing in a watermelon patch. You can't go fishing in a watermelon patch, but you can be happy if you've mine too. You can't roller skate in the buffalo herd. You can't roller skate in the buffalo herd. You can't roller skate in the buffalo herd.